हेलो गाइस, दिस इज रेवंस फ्रॉम डीजी इंटीग्रिटी। वेलकम टू टेक न्यूज़ एपिसोड 80।
डॉक्टर रेड्डीज लेबोरेटरी, द इंडियन पार्टनर ऑफ रशियन डायरेक्ट इन्वेस्टमेंट फंड, सेड इट हैज कमेंस्ड स्पुटनिक वीस इंडिया रोल आउट विद द फर्स्ट डोज बीइंग एडमिनिस्ट्रेटेड इन इंडिया ऑन फ्राइडे एज पार्ट ऑफ लिमिटेड पायलट। द कंपनी ऑल्सो सेड दैट इम्पोर्टेड वैक्सीन हैज बीन प्राइस्ड एट ₹948 पर डोज विद एन एडिशनल 5% GST टू बी चार्ज ऑन इट, पुटिंग द प्राइस एट अराउंड ₹995, जस्ट अंडर ₹1000 ए डोज। Troy has come up with another consultation paper to discuss the validity of prepaid plans. The telecom regulator is looking for inputs for stakeholders on the same matter. Troy said that it has received several complaints from consumers as they feel cheated and tariff plans are confusing. As per the Ericsson Consumer Lab report, 300 million consumers worldwide could upgrade to the 5th generation or 5G technology in 2021, including at least 40 million customers in India within the first year of 5G being made available. Jio phone users get 300 minutes of free calls without recharging, buy one and get one on any plan. Reliance Jio has partnered with the Reliance Foundation to offer additional connectivity minutes for Jio phone users who may be struggling to manage expenses due to COVID-19. Not just new age startups, even established logistics players are betting big on the potential of vaccine delivery using drones in far-flung places of the country. On Thursday, logistics player Blue Dot announced the setting up a new entity, Blue Dot Med Express. Blue Dot Med Express to pilot the usage of drones for delivery of vaccines and emerging medical supplies as part of Telangana's Medical from the Sky project. Battlegrounds Mobile India pre-registration may begin on May 18th. Pre-registration will only be available on Google Play Store. Battlegrounds India release date is yet to be revealed. Call of Duty Mobile is set to get a new event, which will bring some of the most enduring action movie heroes to the game. Next week on May 20th, the official Call of Duty handle has announced that the game will get heroes from the action movies from the 1980s within the game. Even though it is not clear as exactly what role would these characters feature as, among the ones highlighted are the iconic John McClane of the Die Hard franchise, played by Bruce Willis, and John James Rambo of the Rambo franchise, played by Sylvester Stallone. Other cult action heroes from the 1980s movies may also join the roster, but that is not quite clear yet. A new rumor has recently surfaced that claims that Apple is looking to launch the third generation of its AirPods along with a new high fidelity tier of Apple Music on May 18, 2021 through a press release of its official website. POCO M3 Pro 5G specifications have been revealed officially. This handset will ship with a 6.5-inch Full HD Plus display, 90Hz refresh rate and a punch hole cutout. The phone will have a dot-notch display and a dynamic switching. And the company has confirmed that it is going to come with a MediaTek Dimensity 700 processor. This handset is speculated to be a rebrand of the Redmi Note 10 5G. A POCO M3 Pro global launch is scheduled for May 19th. Realme Narzo 30 is confirmed to come with a 48-megapixel primary camera. Other specifications include a 5000mAh battery, 30W fast wired charging and a 90Hz LCD screen. Realme Narzo 30 launch is set for May 18th. Samsung Galaxy A22 5G and 4G renders reveal the complete design. The Galaxy A22 5G will come with a LCD display, triple camera and a MediaTek Dimensity 700 processor. Samsung Galaxy A22 launch date is yet to be revealed. IQ7 Pro Indian variant has been spotted on the IMEI database. The device has a model number of I2017. It is likely different from the IQ7 and IQ7 Legend that has been launched in India. IQ Neo 3S V211 8S spotted on IMEI and Tena certifications. The smartphone is expected to launch soon with the 5G support. IQ Neo 3S specifications may also include the Snapdragon 870 processor, 12GB of RAM and a Full HD Plus display. Honor brand is expected to announce its next flagship lineup following Hawaii selling of this brand. Honor 50 lineup is expected to be announced by the brand as early as this month. The latest news comes from China's 3C, where two of the Honor 50 models were certified with their bundled power adapters. Chinese tech giant Huawei has confirmed today that the company will be launching its true wireless earphone under the FreeBuds lineup in the market, named Huawei FreeBuds 4 at 2:30 PM local time in China on 19th May. The poster shared by the company showcases that the upcoming earphone as well as its charging or carrying case look almost similar to the predecessor. The company has adopted the same in-ear design for the earbuds instead of the full in-ear design. Earlier today, Oppo has announced that it will be launching a new limited variant of its flagship Find X3 Pro smartphone. This version is a Find X3 Pro Mass Exploration Special Edition that will be released tomorrow on 15th May 2021. The variant of Find X3 Pro will arrive with a new color scheme which will distinct from its base color versions. Furthermore, Find X3 Pro Mass Exploration Special Edition will arrive with a 16GB of RAM and up to 512GB of internal storage. Xiaomi has filed patents for 3 new smartphone designs. Among the 3 new designs, 2 of them have slider designs while other has a rotating pop-up camera mechanism. The patents were filed back in 2020 and published only today. Google Pixel 6 and Pixel 6 Pro render show of a unique new design. The phone will come with a new rear camera bridge and a dual tone finish. Google Pixel 6 phone will also get a center-aligned punch hole camera. Google Photos users will lose the free storage they have been enjoying for the last few years by the end of this month. Starting June 1st, the company says that the platform will stop supporting free photos and videos backup, a development first announced last year. Google had explained all high-quality images or videos that users upload on Google Photos would be counted towards the Google Drive storage limit of 15GB. We have previously covered you can download images and videos from the platform to your PC or laptop. Today we will talk about the Google One subscription that ensures you keep using photos and other services without caring about the storage but by paying a premium. All premium plans let you access Google experts and family members for sharing and enjoy extra member benefits. In selected regions, excluding India, users also get access to Google VPN service. Website shows the 3 plans relatively cheaper. The base 100GB is shown at ₹130 per month and ₹1,300 per year, where 200GB plan is shown at ₹200 per month and ₹2,100 per year. The 2TB plan carries a price tag of ₹650 per month and around ₹6,500 per year. SpaceX Starlink will be using Google Cloud services as satellite broadband rollout speedups. Google Cloud will provide cloud services for the Starlink satellite broadband services and get this business ahead of Amazon and Microsoft as a global rollout in underway. Fireside Made in India Clubhouse rival clocks over 1 lakh downloads just a week after the launch. Fireside looks similar to Clubhouse in terms of design and features, though its availability on Android aims to give it an edge over rivals. It also competes against Twitter's own audio-based chatroom spaces that started rolling out in iOS and Android users early in May. Twitter on Wednesday said that it has launched a new state-specific COVID-19 pages in India that surface the latest tweets from people asking for SOS resources as well as those offering help. Microblogging platform currently has been state-specific pages available in places hardest hit by COVID-19. Chhattisgarh, Delhi, Karnataka, Kerala, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra and Punjab. Microblogging platform Twitter may be resuming its verification process as early as next week. The company had announced its intention to bring the program back last year, but has since has been working on the criteria required to verify users and whom the blue tick should be awarded to. The company had asked for user feedback on the matter earlier and had came up with a new policy for verification detailing a bit about who will qualify for verifications in future. Now reverse engineering expert Jane McCon Wong has found that self-serve verification form that users will have to fill in order to get verified.
Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.